Basically, what I like to do when I'm hedge trimming is I like to have a look at the hedge that I'm about to trim, and I like to try and look for the shape that I'm going for. You see, there's almost a natural shape to most plants, and then as the shoots come out, obviously it loses that shape. So what we want to do with the hedge trimmer is really kind of come back to the shape that the plant is naturally. Now with the hedge that I have in question here, it actually requires quite a trim because it's had a long time to grow where it is. So it's actually grown out a whole paving slab further than what it was meant to. So I'm going to give it quite a vigorous trim. Let's see how we go. One little safety tip as I go along. Obviously, with a live power cord like this, you want to make sure that the power is always in the opposite direction to what you're trimming. So because I'm trimming in that direction, I've made sure that my power is plugged in over in that direction. It's always going to be behind me. So as I move down this way, there's no opportunity for the power cord to get in front and get between the blades. That's all you need to do to be safe with an electric hedge. Now what I'm doing is I'm taking it in a line and I'm just going straight down. And trying to keep it as straight as I can so I go straight in. You'll see me gently moving back and forward, kind of like a saw action. And that just helps it to work through the branches so that the machine doesn't have to do too much work. So I've been here for about 10 minutes and I've managed to trim all the way down this passageway. As you can see, there's quite a bit of trimming. Basically what I'm going to do now, because I've done the main bulk majority of it, what I'm going to work towards is I'm going to clear out all this stuff that's here. I'm going to come across and neatly trim the top, trying to keep it at a certain level. Now obviously not the whole lot will be, because there are bits that are much higher and bits that are much lower, and I'm not going to bring the really high bits down too far. And then I'm going to go across the front again just to try and neaten it up, make it look as nice as possible, clear out all the dead stuff, clear out all the bits that I've cut off that haven't fallen off, and then I'll probably go across with just a pair of hedge clippers just to get the last little bit, make as neat as I possibly can. And then my hedge trimming will be done. Easy. So I've cleaned away the vast majority of the waste. And as you can see, there's a lot of the bottom that's actually been missed. Now, some techniques that people often use is they'll actually trim the bottom first and then they'll trim up towards the top. I myself like to just go over and get the bulk of the stuff out and then just go back and trim the end, which is why I've done it the way that I have. But if you want to, you can actually do a line across the bottom so you get that low-lying shrub that can get left behind, and then you can work your way up towards the top. It's just a different preference. Either way works, and they really both bring about the same result in pretty much the same amount of time. It's just different techniques. But there you go, you can see how it's starting to look, it's coming together. Just need to go across the top, trim across there, and then neaten up, including the bottoms along here. And my hedge will be trimmed. Now as you can see up against the bricks, there's a little bit left, just close, but that's actually not too bad. Now if I wanted to, I probably could get that with a hedge trimmer, but for me I find it just as easy to go and get a pair of manual hedge shears and just come and snip just along the edge. That'd be 5 minutes, probably take me 5 minutes with the trimmer, but it'll be a bit more hassle. So I'm just going to grab some head shears and just clean that up. So to demonstrate very quickly, if it's nice and easy, you just do one smooth motion. When I'm going across the top, I like to go one way and then go back the other, so you can get both directions. Now, if it's a bit harder, you have to get the saw action into it. And this is normal when you're going down the side. So it's like this. And that really helps with it. Now, another little trick for you. With the power, oftentimes, the cable can become undone if you just plug it in like that. What you want to do is cross them past each other, wrap them around so it's like a granny knot almost, and then plug it in so you make a knot. Pull it tight, but not too tight because you don't want to ruin the cables. So then as you're moving, if you're pulling on the cable, it actually tightens the knot as opposed to pulling the plug out. So there you have it. A nicely trimmed hedge, a nice clean double paver path. It took me about an hour. The actual trimming of the hedge was not difficult, but the cleanup obviously takes a bit more work because the hedge trimmer really does such a good job. It takes off so much in such a quick time that you obviously have to clean everything up that you take off. But I'm very happy with that. I hope you learnt a little bit about how to do hedge trimming using electric hedge trimmer. That's all for this edition of Aussie Green Thumb on camera.